Welcome back to King of Thieves, everybody. Here's another base I just attacked. This one is by Darwin. And there's still room in his guild. Maybe come and join us. I'll also be around for another 2 days. This is a double sword jump. So you have to reset the blood tone, then return and do the sword jump again. So here's how you do it. I guess you know that jump, but then the next jump, I did it in the end by tapping quickly with a single finger, jumping halfway early, and then I made that jump. So actually there are three ways how you can jump. You can double tap with two fingers, jumping way earlier than normal. Then you can tap with a single finger, jumping normally, and then you can delay your jump and slide up the wall a bit and then make it. But this is just in between. Yeah, and then you made it, you can drop down and that's it really. So here's how you die. You can fail the first jump, of course. And for example, right here, I jumped too high and then I couldn't make this jump. If you make it, you can't jump straight up. You have to return there. But do not slide too short. If your timing is off, you'll die down there. And then you can fail the sword jump a second time. With disabled trap by default, you disable the bloodhound. So this is pretty good. Now you only have to do a single sword jump. Whereas with Gang of Thieves, you just have to do everything like before. So this took me about half an hour before I learned that jump. Yeah, this is how you fail it, but then I made it. And then I made it a second time, of course, doing it just the way like before. In total, this took me about an hour to record, though it isn't that bad. I think you can save it. So, thanks to Darwin for this layout. Maybe join his guild next video on Saturday. Bye!